Good afternoon, students. This is Medical Biology Department, lecture number 3. The topic of lecture is Medical Biology, Medical Arachnoentomology. In this lecture, we will tell about organisms from phylum Arthropoda, which are human parasites or vectors of different human disorders. Medical arachnoentomology studies the vectors, vector-borne diseases, causative agents of diseases caused by organisms from phylum Arthropoda. Systematic position of phylum Arthropoda. This is kingdom Animalia, subkingdom Metazoa, phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda is most successful phylum of animals, both in diversity and distribution, and in number of species and organisms. Phylum Arthropoda includes many classes, but the most medical important are the next classes. These are class Crustacea, Arachnida, and class Insecta. The most medical importance has class Insecta, but most medical importance has class Insecta, but today we tell about class Crustaceans and class Arachnida. The medical importance of class Insecta will be topic of next lecture. So the most medical importance of Arthropoda has class Crustacea. These are cyclops, crabs, crayfishes, class Arachnida. Each includes scorpions, spiders, ticks, and mites. And class Insecta. These are mosquitoes, flies, sandflies, and others. General morphological characteristics of phylum Arthropoda. These are bilaterally symmetrical, tripoblastic, metamerically segmented animals. Body organization is of an organ system level. The body covered with a thick cutaneous cuticle forming an exoskeleton. Body segments are usually bilateral and jointed appendages with varied functions as jaws, gills, legs, etc. A body is divided into head, thorax, and abdomen. In some Arthropoda, the head and thorax often fused to form a cephalothorax. The muscles of Arthropoda are not continuous and they separate into striped muscles which provide the movement of appendages. The body cavity is hemocoel. The trucellum is reduced to the spaces of genital and excretory organs. The complete digestive system, which starts from mouth and finishes by anus. Mouth pads of Arthropoda are very different and adapted for for various modes of feeding. Open circulatory system with dorsal arch and arteries, but without capillaries. So the blood freely washed the inner organs. Respiration is different for different classes and orders. The respiration can be generally by body surface, gills for aquatic forms, trachea or book lungs in terrestrial forms. We don't have true nephridia. Excretion is provided by green glands or malpighian tubules or coxal glands. The nervous system is typically annelidian, with a dorsal brain connected with a nerve ring to double ventral nerve cord, which provide the innervation of inner organs and systems. Cilias are absent from all parts of the body. The arthropoda have very developed sense organs, as eyes. The eyes in arthropoda can be simple or compound. Chema and tactile receptors, balancing and auditory organs. Where most of arthropoda have separated sexes, and they have the sexual dimorphism, so the female differs from males. Reproduction organs and ducts paired. For arthropoda, the internal fertilization is characterized. They are oviparous or ovoviviparous. In most of arthropoda, development is indirect. Indirect development, this is development with larval stages or metamorphosis. When the larva differs from adult organisms. For some species, the parthenogenesis is characterized. So, for most arthropoda, the metamorphosis is characterized. Metamorphosis, this is presence of larva in life cycle. There are two types of incomplete development or two types of metamorphosis. This is development with complete metamorphosis and development with incomplete metamorphosis. The incomplete metamorphosis has three stages and complete metamorphosis has four stages. Complete metamorphosis. This is type of metamorphosis which includes four stages. These are egg, larva, pupa, and adult. This type of development is characterized for flies, mosquitoes, sand flies, fleas. Incomplete metamorphosis include Incomplete metamorphosis includes three stages. This is egg, larva, sometimes present nymph stages and adult. So egg, larva and adult. Incomplete or hemimetabolous development. This is development when the larva look like similar as adult, but each differs by inner organs, some outer organs and others. This type of metamorphosis is characterized for ticks, mites, lice, bugs, cockroaches. So the main stages of incomplete metamorphosis, this is egg, larva or nymph, and adult. The first class which we study in arthropods is class crustaceans. Crustaceans, these are mostly aquatic organisms. These are cyclops, lobsters, crabs, crayfish. The body of crustacean is consist of cephalothorax and abdomen. The cephalothorax has two pairs of antenna, sense organs and feeding parts. Abdomen contains respiratory organs and sex organs. The number of legs vary in different types of crustaceans. The medical importance has next crustacean. These are cyclops. The cyclops are intermediate hosts for a fish tapeworm. This is Diphyllobotrium latum or Diphyllobotrium mansoni, and it is intermediate host for Dracunculus medinensis.
Я спросила, да, я спрашивала у Сибирского, она сказала, за чего вот я когда в Белске ходила, и она сказала, да, за чего тебе не стоит продать.
importance in crustacean crabs and crayfish have too. They are intermediate hosts for Paragonimus westermani and Paragonimus ringeri. The second class which we will study in Arthropoda is class Arachnida. Class Arachnida, these are true terrestrial animals, which includes near of 100,000 species. This class includes spiders, scorpions, ticks, and mites. Most arachnids are adapted to kill prey with poison, glands, stingers, or fangs. The body of arachnids is divided into two parts, cephalothorax and abdomen. The main feature of arachnida, they have four pairs of legs, and they have one pair of chelicerae and one pair of pedipalps. Pedipalps and chelicerae helps in chewing and catching of food. In class Arachnidae, there are four orders, and the most medical importance are orders of scorpions, spiders, and acarina. So, order scorpions, order Acarina, ticks and mites, and order Aranea, these are spiders. Order scorpions. These are animals with a long segmented tail. And their pedipalps are modified as pinchers. The long tail of scorpions finishes by spine with poisonous gland. Most scorpions' stings are not worse, but some species can be very dangerous. These are nocturnal organisms. Mostly they live in warm, hot countries, feed by other animals. Here you can see the morphological characteristics of scorpions. Their body consists of cephalothorax and long segmented abdomen. The last segment, telson, is bent into sharp hook, and each base of this hook there are two poisonous glands. The medical importance of scorpions. I told which the most scorpions are not dangerous, but some species are very dangerous, and the symptoms of scorpion bite include severe pain, inflammation, swelling in place of bite. Sometimes the muscular spasm occur, the death can cause by respiratory failure, pulmonary edema, and shock. The some compounds from scorpion venom can be used for creating of new drugs. venoms of some scorpions are hemolytic. So the reaction of this sting is mainly local and stimulates the viper snake bite, but the scorpion sting will have only one hole in the center of reddish area. Where edema, pain, and reddish is present inside of sting. So here you can see the stings of scorpions. How do they look like? In this slide you can see the effects of venom of scorpions. So the sting of scorpion can cause the tachycardia, hypertension, myocarditis, bradycardia, muscle spasm, paralysis and other symptoms. Mostly the scorpions can cause severe problems for old people, for small children, and for people with allergy to scorpion venom. So this heart condition are characterized mostly for these groups of people. The second order from class Arachnida is order Araneae. Each includes spiders. These are terrestrial organisms, but some of them are secondary water organisms. Mostly of spiders produces the spin webs from fluid proteins forced from spinnerets, modified appendages as posterior part of abdomen containing pairs of silk glands. Some spiders are poisonous and cause severe damage for human body. As other arachnida, the araneae or spiders has four pairs of legs. The body is divided into cephalothorax and abdomen. The head doesn't have antenna, but each has calyces and pedipalps. These are mouthparts of spiders. Uh, where spiders have eight simple eyes which can detect light and motion. Sensory set detects air currents, web vibrations and other stimuli. Spiders' vision is usually very poor. The front pair of appendages are calicerae, are the ones which contain the poisonous gland. The second pair are pedipalps. They are more smaller and they are used by male during the mating. The head bears four pairs of eyes, the arrangement of which can be very useful for identification of the several different kinds of spiders. Most spiders breathe through trachea, but some spiders have both book lungs and trachea. As I told, some spiders are very poisonous and can be very dangerous for people. In Crimea, the poisonous spider lives. This is karakurt, which means a black spider. After fertilization, the female kills the male. At the top of Calicera, each has poisonous gland with a neurotoxic effect. The females are poisonous and males are not poisonous. Mortality is near of 4%. Mostly the bite of this spider is dangerous for small children, old people and people with allergic reaction to poison of this spider. Tarantula. These are a Russian spider which live in south of Russia. The female is poisonous. The bite causes pain like a wasp sting. Sometimes it causes a severe symptoms of poisoning. Black widow spider. It lives mostly in USA, where abdomen has the abdomen has red round circles on black abdomen. It can cause a severe headache, difficult breathing, chills, sometimes loss of consciousness, high blood pressure, and others. Wolf spider. It lives in USA too. It has two large eyes in the middle and six small eyes on the sides. The symptoms are the same to black widow spider. Brown. Bravo brown recluse. This spider lives in in United States too. It is a very dangerous spider because each cause the necrosis of skin and muscles in a site of biting. Brown recluse spider. On this slide you can see the stages of destroying of tissue in site of biting of this spider. The next order of class Arachnida is order Acarina. It includes ticks and mites. The medical importance of ticks and mites. Ticks, these are organisms which has more large size, and the mites, these are microscopical organisms. Each includes a causative agent of some human disorders. The medical importance of ticks. These are carriers of causative agent of human disorders. For ticks, the transovarian transmission of parasites is characterized. So it means the a female transfer the pathological bacteria and viruses to ovums and to new generation of ticks. So as a result of this, the ticks act as reservoir hosts for some human disorders. For example, for tick encephalitis. For ticks, the omovampirism is characterized. So the female suck the blood of males, and it causes the infection of females. There are two suborders in order Acarina. These are parasitiforms and acariforms. The parasitiforms mostly includes ticks, and acariforms mostly includes mites. The parasitiforms ticks includes the ticks from family Axadida, Argazida, and Gamazida. All the most organisms from order Acarina are ectoparasites of human, animals, and plants. Calicera and pedipalps of Acarina are modified for piercing, biting, and sucking of fluids. There are four pairs of legs in adult. So we can divide all Acarina into ticks and mites. The ticks are large macroscopic organisms. The body with short or no hair. The calicers and pedipalps take part in formation of hypostome, which exposed and armed with teeth. All ticks are parasitic. The mites are small, microscopic. They have body with long hair, hypostome hidden, unarmed, no teeth. The some mites are parasitic, but some are free living organisms. So tick. The adult tick has four pairs of legs. Each has mouth parts. Each has name hypostome. The body is not segmented, and the fusion of cephalothorax and abdomen happens in ticks. The ticks are small rounded organelles. The shape of body is spherical or oval. The body is not divided into parts and no segmented. Calicera and pedipalpa are fused together and form the proboscis, which is named gnathostome. Axadidae ticks keep their self on the host body with oral appendage, hypostome, massive appendix with the teeth. Agent of disease are transferred by oral organs of ticks or with saliva. Sucking way of agent transmission is called inoculation. It is quite painless because the anesthetic substance penetrates into wound with saliva. The oral apparatus can be nibbled, thrusted, kicked, and sucking depending of nourishment type. The ticks have four pairs of segmented extremities which have claws and pillows. The basic segment is coxa, which connects with he barely firmly. During our feeding, we have inserted their head under the skin and are engorging themselves or on the blood. Diseases carried by ticks means that you should have yourself checked after you find ticks. They are harder to find. The digestive system is ramified with blind appendix, which is reservoir during of blood sucking. The breathing of ticks is provided by trachea, but some species have skin respiration. The circulation system is reduced. All ganglions of nervous system make a common network. Tactile and olfactory organs are most developed sensory organs. Eyes sometimes are absent. Ticks have separated sexes. There are three families of ticks: Oxazida, Argazida, and Gamazida. All ticks we can divide into large groups. These are soft ticks and hard ticks. Soft ticks, this is family Argazida. Hard ticks, these are families Oxazida and Gamazida. The hard ticks have covers on dorsal surface. In male, this cover covers the whole dorsal surface. In female, each covers particularly. Soft ticks are without dorsal sheath. Their mouth parts are subterminally attached and not visible from the dorsal view. So here you can see the examples of soft ticks. And examples of hard ticks. Life cycle of ticks. Their indirect development with incomplete metamorphosis is characterized for ticks. The female lays eggs. From eggs, the larva hatches out. The larva differs from adults by few characteristics. So in larva, only six legs present. The respiratory and reproductive system is absent in larva. So the respiration of larva by all surface of body. The larvas feed by blood of small animals and birds, molds, and transfer to nymph. The nymph has eight legs or four pairs of legs, but it doesn't have reproductive system, but each has a respiratory system. After some molting, the nymph transfer to adults, males and females, which has genital apertura, sexual differentiation and pigmentation. The males and adult males and females feed by blood of large animals. I remember you about trans-ovarian transmission of viruses and bacteria in ticks. Suba female transfer the different pathogens inside of eggs to next generation. So the larvas born were infected by different viruses and bacteria. So as a result of this, the ticks act as reservoir hosts for some bacteria and viruses. So the main feature of ticks from family Axodida, this is present of scutum on dorsal patch of tick. The ticks from family Axodida have hypostome, which provide the blood sucking and attachment of ticks to the host body. In males, the scutum occupies entire dorsal aspect. In females, the scutum occupies the dorsal aspect particularly. This is structure of hypostome of ticks. The hypostome of ticks is armed and it helps to attachment of tick to a host body. These are different species of ticks from family Axodida, and on this slide you can see the changes of ticks, of size of ticks after feeding. On this slide you can see the differences between larva, nymph and adults of ticks. The medical importance of ticks, they are vectors for many human disorders. The ticks from family Axodida are vectors for very dangerous disease, this is Lyme disease, where wild animals are reservoir host for Borrelia burgdorferi, this is causative agent of Lyme disease. The ticks feed by blood of wild animals and infected by this bacteria. After this, the ticks bite humans and cause infection of human by Lyme disease. So Lyme disease, this is bacterial disorder. The first symptom of this disorder, this is round erythema or round red circles near of tick bite. The other symptoms of Lyme disease, these are heart complication, hot, swelling, painful jaw, inflammation of joints, insomnia, flu-like symptoms, paralysis of face, hearing loss. Another disease which is transferred by ticks, this is a virus of tick encephalitis. The tick encephalitis is transferred by ticks. The reservoir host for this virus are wild animals. This virus circulate in blood of wild animals, and when the tick bites the wild animal, the infection of tick happens. After this tick transfer this disorder to a healthy human and cause human infection. So the ticks are vectors for Lyme disease. These are mostly ticks from family Axodida. The ticks can be vectors for babesiosis, Powassan encephalitis, for Rocky Mountain spotted fever, tularemia, ehrlichiosis, southern tick associated rash illness. What you should remember, the nymphs and adults become very active at spring because the ticks don't feed during the winter. They sleep, so when they wake up at the spring, they are very hungry and catch two people. Mites. The mites are microscopical acarina. Most of them don't have any eyes. And most of mites covers by hairs. The medical importance we will tell about two species of mites. This is Sarcoptes scabii and Demodex folliculorum. Today our first parasite is Sarcoptes scabii. This is each mite, and this is causative agent of scabious or itching disease. This parasite is causative agent of scabious, but it is not vector for any diseases. This is microscopical organism. The size of this parasite is near 0.4 millimeters. Each covers by long hairs where cephalothorax and abdomen fused together, and each has four pairs of very short legs. This parasite don't have any eyes. This parasite burrows into human skin and causes scabies. Gravid female burrows the skin and lay eggs in tunnels. By this way, the parasite causes severe itching. Here you can see the people with scabies. So this parasite causes severe itching, and on skin of people with scabies, you can see the small tunnels, you can see the vesicle, and you can see the wounds from itching, from scratching. And you can see the wounds from scratching of skin. For scabies, the sexual dimorphism is characterized. The female is more larger as male. The most scientists think which after fertilization the males die. And females burrow tunnels for laying of eggs. Here you can see the life cycle of Sarcoptes scabby. The female lays the tunnels and lays eggs. The eggs are very small and microscopical. After 2-3 days, the larva hatches out. Each feed by epithelial cells and molts into nymph stage. The nymph stage molts and transfer into adult male and female. So after 1-2 months from eggs, the adults male and female develops, and after fertilization, the female lays eggs. So each burrows tunnels and lays eggs in these tunnels. Each causes very severe itching. The people scratch and the eggs move to surface of skin, to human clothes. If you shake hand to this person, or if you wear the clothes of this person, each can cause, you can infect by this disorder. So the way of infection by this disorder is contact way. But mostly this parasite prefer the tender parts of our skin with a thin skin. So on this slide you can see the parts of our body which mostly affected by this parasite. The transmission of this disorder is by person to person and fomites. So you can infect by this disorder if you use the clothes or bed line of other people during of shake hand of with other person, or if you sit or touch two surfaces which were in contact with infected person. In severe cases, the parasite can infect whole human body, and this very severe type of scabies has name Norwegian scabies. It mostly characterized for people with AIDS. Diagnosis of scabies. The diagnosis of scabies should be confirmed by identifying the mite or mite eggs. This can be done by carefully removing the mite from the end of its burrow using the tip of a needle or by obtaining a skin scraping. And you should examine your biological material under microscope. Under microscope, you can see the adult mites or eggs of these parasites. Very often, the doctors diagnose this disorder on base of clinical picture and symptoms of patient. The preventive measures against of this parasite, this is treatment of sick people, don't use the clothes of other people, wash the hands more often as you can, don't use bed line of other people, clean your home, your surfaces, and others. The next disorder, this is demodecosis. The causative agent of this disorder is Demodex folliculorum. This is causative agent of demodecosis. It is small microscopical parasite. It has worm-like structure of body with four short legs. The size of this parasite is near of 0.4 millimeters in length. In human body, two species of Demodex can live. This is Demodex brevis and Demodex folliculorum. The parasite lives within hair follicles on human skin and feeding by dead skin cells. As other organisms, as other mites, the Demodex has indirect development with incomplete metamorphosis. So three stages are present in life cycle of Demodex. This is ovum, larva, and adult mite. in human body, two species of Demodex can live. This is Demodex folliculorum and Demodex brevis. The both of these species live in hair follicles or fat glands. This parasite multiplies in these structures, blocked them and cause inflammation. Mostly these parasites prefer the skin of face, neck, or chest. The Demodex folliculorum is more commonly localized in hair follicles or sebaceous glands of face, and the Demodex brevis more commonly found on the neck or chest. The both of this parasite cause inflammation of hair follicles or sebaceous glands. The Demodex brevis mostly feed by fat from sebaceous glands, but the Demodex folliculorum mostly feeds by skin cells and sebum for nourishment. Very often the Demodex folliculorum destroys the hair's root, which causes the hairless. Demodex folliculorum is a mite which is normally located on the face, in hair follicles, around cheeks, nose, eyebrows, eyelashes, and forehead. They also can be found in other parts of the body. The science have different opinions about these organisms, because at 2014, the studies found, which were 400 of people over age of 18, had mite DNA or have mite DNA, to DNA of the Demodex folliculorum on their faces. So they do conclusion which the mites are universal inhabitants of adult humans. And some scientists think which these organisms live in harmony on normal human skin. And this is as commensal organism of our body. Although no causal relationship exists, they are however present in higher numbers in rosacea, and this is the basis for treating rosacea with metronidazole and ivermectin. The presence of the Demodex mites when casually linked to skin lesions of rosacea is called demodicosis. All in all, the presence of the mite and the symptoms of rosacea is an association only, and this is why giving a cause to effect explanation is so confusing. So the scientists don't decide is the modex folliculorum a parasite or not? Because of the scientists think the studies shows which the parasite present on face of 70% of people. But in some people, the presence of parasite causes the severe inflammation of hair follicles and development of rosacea or acne. The mostly scientists think which mostly the normal skin contains the small number of this organism. Normal or dry skin contains small number of this organism. But if the skin is fat and produce large number of fat, it causes the reproduction of this parasite and they start to harm to human body, to human face. But the modex folliculorum has indirect development with incomplete metamorphosis. So in life cycle, the egg, larva, and nymph and adult are present. The parasite causes harm by blocking of sebaceous glands or hair follicles by large number of these organisms. This blocking causes the inflammation of sebaceous gland or inflammation of hair follicle. And we can see this inflammation as a development of acne, the inflammation of skin, the reddish color of skin. Sometimes the parasite live in hair follicles of eyelashes and can cause blepharitis. In severe cases, it can cause the inflammation of sebaceous glands or hair follicles of the face, neck, breast, and this is rosacea, formation of acne, pityriasis folliculorum, this is pus inflammation of sebaceous gland. The way of infection by these organisms are this is using of towels or clothes of other people. If you tell about women, using of makeup of other people, using of bedline of other people. And we can find this disease in dogs too. the diagnosis of this disorder is based on removal of hairs with hair root. After this, the microscopic examination of this hair root happens, and we can find the adult Demodex folliculorum or larva or eggs. The lecture is finished. Goodbye.